ISO 80369 evaluates the functionality of small bore connectors for liquids and gases in healthcare applications. These connectors, also known as Luer connectors, are universally used in medical applications to ensure that medical products such as syringes, catheters, and IV hubs will reliably connect to one another, regardless of their manufacturer. The standard includes 8 sections. The first provides general requirements and background related to Luer connectors and their applications. Sections 2 through 7 discuss application-specific details, such as connector geometry and testing criteria. Section 20 includes the complete procedures for each test defined by the standard. It also provides alternative methodologies to obtain variable data as opposed to attribute data, which effectively reduces the required sample size. There are 8 testing annexes evaluating closure quality through applied forces, torques, and internal pressures to simulate typical and extraordinary use cases. The Instron ISO 80369 system is built upon a single column universal testing machine with biaxial capabilities and is designed to support the testing of all annexes. The device-specific fixturing comes in 2 main configurations. The first is a highly flexible pneumatic grip with interchangeable faces designed to match various hub geometries. The entire grip assembly is mounted on a manual XY assembly to ensure consistent alignment between the device under the test and reference connector. The second configuration is specifically designed to support standard syringe sizes. In this setup, the syringe body is secured by a pneumatic lathe chuck, while the rotating Luer collar is secured by an adjustable pneumatic side-acting grip. The rest of the fixture is universal, encompassing the reference connector, a pneumatic slip ring to allow for multiple rotations, a pressure sensor, and pneumatic valves. The 2 valves enable the device to be pressurized to positive or negative pressures, depending on the annex. The separate pneumatic control box allows the user to set the target pressures as defined by the standard. Each test includes 2 distinct sections. The assembly procedure, which consistently secures the device to the reference connector, and the test procedure, which assesses the performance of the closure. Concentric and angular alignment between the device and reference connector is of the utmost importance to maintain the assembly within specification and for ensuring reliable connection between the device and the reference connector. The testing system is designed to allow the operator to remove the assembled device and reference connector, allowing specimens to be set aside for stress cracking while the system is used for additional testing. Annex B, leakage by pressure decay, requires a pressure of 300 to 330 kilopascals be applied and held for a period of 15 to 20 seconds to determine whether pressure leakage is below a specified limit. Annex C, falling drop positive pressure liquid leakage, is analogous to Annex B, but using liquid as the medium rather than air. This annex is not supported with the standard testing system, but can be added as a separate module. In most cases, this test can be skipped, as the standard specifies that either Annex B or C can be performed to satisfy leakage test requirements. Annex D, subatmospheric pressure air leakage, requires a pressure of negative 80 to 88 kilopascals be applied and held for a period of 15 to 20 seconds to determine whether pressure leakage is below a specified limit. It's important to note that the following mechanical testing annexes will have different load and torque requirements based on both the application and format of the connector. More specifically, whether it is a Luer lock or Luer slip. Annex F, resistance to separation from axial load, applies an axial load to the device over a period of 10 to 15 seconds and requires the operator to visually confirm there is no separation between the device under test and reference connector. Annex G, resistance to separation from unscrewing, applies a counterclockwise torque force to the assembled connector for a period of 15 to 20 seconds. Requiring the operator to confirm that there is no separation between the device under test and reference connector. Annex H, resistance to overriding, applies an additional clockwise torque force to the assembled device for a period of 5 to 10 seconds to determine whether the threads of the Luer connector are damaged. Whenever developing or modifying your test procedures, we recommend that you always consult the full standard. To learn more, contact us or visit instron.com.